I have some new stuff to use when making videos, and so now I don't have to do all in one take. Look, I can make cuts. I'm pretty excited about it. I really am. I have to get used to situating myself before I start talking, because I found when I was editing this other video, which I'm not going to post because it's boring, that, like, I would start to say things before I was really in a position to, like, cut to it. So I need to, like, be, you know, like, professional, I guess. And yeah, so, yay, blog. I have little dingly danglies on my wrists. So, if you hear that, that's what that annoying jingly sound is. So, I was thinking about something today, and I was thinking about other YouTubers, YouTube people, about how, like, all the videos I've been watching lately, everybody talks really, really, really fast. Like, if it's just them, if it's just, like, vlog, just me, or, like, just the person, that, like, they talk super, super, super fast. And I'm like, why do you talk so fast? And I realized it. People have short attention spans. And, you know, they don't want to sit there and listen to somebody who stutters the whole time and goes, what am I going to talk about now? And I realized I do that. And it's like, I don't even know how you guys stand it. So I've decided that I'm going to try and talk as fast as I can and get out my message as fast as I can. But the problem is, most times, I don't even know what my message is before I start making the video. And it's kind of like, I just go at it and I just talk and I just, you know, talk about things, random things, and that's it. And then I think of the point and the title after I'm done. Also, what I want to talk to you guys about today is a thing that is happening right now called YouTube Project for Awesome. And at first, like, I got online this morning and I, you know, checked my YouTube and I had a lot of subscription updates. And I was like, wow! All of my favorite people are updating all at once. How lucky am I? It's like Christmas a week early. Christmas is in 1 week. And all of their videos were this Project for Awesome. And I was like, what is that? And I found out that you make a video to, like, about your favorite charity, and you're like, Project for Awesome, go donate here. And I was like, that is such a cool idea. I should do that. And I don't have a favorite charity, because I'll be honest, I'm kind of a bad Samaritan. I don't, you know, so I was researching stuff, and, like, there's all these really famous ones that everybody already, you know, donates to anyway, like Toys for Tots and, you know, breast cancer awareness and all that stuff. And I mean, those are great causes, don't get me wrong, but, like, you know, you really want to promote one that's, like, rare and that people really don't think about, because that's the point, is to get the awareness out via YouTube. And there's just all these different ones, and I couldn't pick. And so I guess, like, this doesn't really count, because it's not, I'm not, you know, saying donate to this specific thing, and that's kind of the point of Project for Awesome. But it's holiday season, and, you know, there are a lot of people who aren't as fortunate, who don't have, like, you know, who don't really get to celebrate this season, and possibly, like, you know, you and I get to and stuff. Like, I mean, I'll admit, I have a great holiday. I do. I love, you know, seeing my friend, my family, and everybody, and everybody's happy and everything, and, you know, food and stuff. It's all really great, and a lot of people don't have that. And so, you know, just take a moment and think about it, and think about, sort of like, do a Thanksgiving thing. Like, think about what you're thankful for and all the things that you have, and, you know, how lucky you are to have the life that you have, because not everybody, you know, has it as good as you do. And obviously, if you're sitting on a computer and watching YouTube, you probably aren't that bad off. You at least have access to a computer, and a lot of people don't have that. So basically, just, you know, you pass by that bell ringer outside Walmart or whatever when you're out buying your last minute gift, you know, put something in there. You know, tip your baristas. Tip your waitresses. Just, this is the holiday season. It's the season of giving, you know. Just think about that. Just be compassionate and give, you know. I mean, what can you lose? You know, the spare change from the bottom of your purse. Just yesterday, I found this whole, like, my old wallet from high school, and it had, like, all these pennies in it that I just shoved in there because, you know, I didn't I didn't have anywhere else to put them, so I just put them in there, and, you know, that little bit, it helps. I mean, it's probably like 50 cents or something like that. I don't know. There's a lot of pennies in there, and, you know, every little bit helps, so give, you know. This is the season to help others, you know, reach out to your fellow man, so everybody have a happy holidays. I'll definitely update before, you know, Christmas, because, you know, like I said, I don't have anything else to do, and I'll probably make some, like, sort of creative video or something. I don't know. I have some ideas, but I don't have a camera person. It's just me. I might as well be living in a log cabin out, like, in the middle of nowhere, like in La Push, Washington or something. So anyway, have a happy holidays, and eat lots of pie, because I think that's, you know, and eggnog, drink eggnog, because that's what you're supposed to do around the holiday season, and give, and be happy, and be with your family. And I know I'm asking a lot, but it's Christmas, guys, come on. Something else I want to talk to you guys about today is, I forgot it. Okay.